Hey everybody, it's me, Liz, coming to you live from my kitchen. It's Take Five Tuesday. Hello. I'm burping away over here. I just drank like half a bottle of lemon lime seltzer. And then just as the camera turned on, I went bleh. There's still more in there though. Hello, it's Take Five Tuesday. Today I'm doing the ingredients from that potato video I did a couple of weeks ago. I'm using the ingredients suggested by a user named Neurocosm. Neurocosm has his own food blog on the internet. I will put it in the video description. It's called grubdude.com, I believe, or .net. Might be .net. I'll put it in the description. He loves playing with food and reading about playing with food and interesting things done with food. He featured my blueberry brie burger a couple of weeks ago. And so today his ingredients are cabbage, olives, which I only have green in the house, which I'm really sad about because I'd rather use black olives because they're more neutral in flavor and I could have done different things, but there you go. Because as you know, I'm not really excited about spending lots of extra money. That's what my cooking really is mostly about, making something out of what you already have. You know, obviously I go and buy stuff for certain meals, but I like to use what's in the house too. So I've got his ingredients are green olives, cabbage, pretzels. Did you see that? Pretzels. If I was more ambitious, I'd make some big soft German pretzel. What else? Ramen noodles, which are off cam at the moment. Here, I'll show you some. I've cooked them in their own broth and now that I put cold water on them and they're cooling. Ramen noodles, cabbage, green olives, pretzels, and hot dogs. So I went around about this morning. I mean, like all day. I mean, like for 2 days. I went round and round about this meal. And what I'm doing is my original idea, which I find fairly unoriginal. Well, what do you think you'd do with those ingredients? Well, you've got cabbage and olives. Olives, especially green ones, make it hard to do much of anything different. Because they don't necessarily taste great in various concoctions, but I love them nonetheless. But so what are you gonna do? You're gonna make slaw. I mean, I could have made some sort of cockamamie stuffed ca here are all the ideas I had. Stuffed cabbage rolls with a meat mixture made of hot dogs and olives and breadcrumbs made from pretzels. But that's the other thing. I don't rush out and buy ingredients for my cooking videos. And I also want to make something that mom and I can eat for supper that we like. So in, when I strive to be unusual and MacGyver-ish, that's fun, like egg in the hole pizza even bro nuts. But sometimes, when your ingredients are such as these, you can't be serving your mother olive and pretzel quiche for dinner. It just, we wouldn't like it, we wouldn't finish it, and ew. So, I am making us a slaw here of the cabbage and the olive. Now, Beth, Cooking and Crafting Channel, wrote in my video description of my video yesterday, the fried rice balls, I think, and she wrote, "Well, if I had pretzels and hot dogs, no brainer, I'd be making, like a pretzel corn dog only with pretzels or something like that." And that's exactly what I had planned to do. Excuse me, there's another seltzer burp. I'm certainly the only cooking vlogger on YouTube for burps in their video. I can, well, ever since Paper Cut 777 left. He left that legacy to me, unknowingly, of course. So, where was I? I don't know. The burp threw me all off my game. I was telling you my different ideas. Oh, I tried, but I was on something else, wasn't I? Oh, I said I'm gonna make a slaw of slaw, olives, and ramen noodles, a pasta salad. And I thought because I'm making those, oh, I was talking about making pretzel corn dogs. That's it. I thought that that's very American slash possibly German because of the pretzels. So I was going to make this an Oriental salad, but now I'm not going to. I'm going to make it as American as apple pie. because, you know, the flavorings on the dressing, which I'm allowing myself as a core ingredient because, you know, you can't just sit there and eat a bowl of slaw with no dressing on it. I was going to use sesame oil and vinegar and soy sauce like I like so much in a cold pasta pork salad that my mom makes. But I've done a lot of Asian or faux Asian lately. And these dogs are going to be, you know, dipped in mustard and German American. So in that light, I think I'm going to make our ramen pasta salad. Wait for it. I'm going to use zesty ranch dressing. I just am. I think coleslaw is always with a mayonnaise-based something or other. I always doctor my salads. Like, I like prepared dressings, but very few. I don't like any of the ones like wishbone and stuff that have guar gum. I certainly don't like any low-calorie ones. If I'm going to buy a ready dressing, I very often make my own with just balsamic and oil and spices and stuff. But if I'm going to buy a ready-made one, then I like to either doctor it or use two different ones. So like Newman's balsamic, it's just balsamic and vinegar and stuff. There's no thickeners and other yucky stuff in it. So I'll use a splash of that to get a real tartness going. And then I'll use a little blue cheese or a little ranch so that it's lightly mayonnaise-y. And then with that tart snap. And so that's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to take my, how many minutes are we at for a salad? 6, and I haven't even done the made pretzel dogs yet. Okay, so I'm going to take my zesty ranch that somebody just introduced me to. I don't know how long they've been making it, but I didn't know they made spicy ranch. It's freaking incredible. I used to always poo-poo ranch dressing because it was so... You know, every American, it was all about ranch, and you had to have ranch on your pizza crust, and ranch on this, and ranch on that, and people being addicted to ranch, and I don't know, it just pissed me off, and I stayed away from it. But now I've had it, and I've, like apple products, and having taken a bite of the apple, I have been ranched now for about 3 or 4 years. I'm just going to use white vinegar because it has that real crackin' tang that cuts through any fatty anything. And of course we are going to have, and of course my beloved, beloved, beloved celery in any form. And I can only find the salt right now, which is, I have some seed up there too. I'd rather use celery seed, but I can't find it. And I don't want to take up all your time. So... dash of that'll put that celery flavor in there for me. So there you have it. Gonna chill that up. It's a ballpark slaw with olives. No, you can't beat ballpark. Yes, it's ramen noodles. It's a pasta salad. Ballpark, no. Asian ballpark pasta salad slaw. As usual, you'll see what I name it at the end. It can't be bad. We are going to really enjoy that. And like I do with all pasta salads, I mix it up now, and then I add more dressing, more vinegar, more everything later. Because I like my salads a little wetter. I hate dry pasta salad. And this pasta is going to suck up all that moisture right now. And in a couple of hours, it's just going to be a big ball of dough till I break it back up again with some more moisture. So there you have it. Yummy you. And I'm gonna make pretzel dogs. I'll be right back. Hey, everybody, I'm back. And now I'm working on the pretzel corn dog. Faux corn dog portion of the take five ingredients. I am about to smash up some my pretzels. I have them in a, look at that cute little bag left over, my mom had left over from Christmas time. I'm using one of those because they're thicker and so crumbs won't go everywhere. A lot of people use a rolling pin to do this. I don't have a lot of space on the counter and usually I just do it this way. I usually just take the back of a heavy spoon, usually this metal ladle. You gotta keep the bag unzipped, otherwise it pops the bag Oopsie, you don't want to break the bowl. It pops the bag and the crumbs go everywhere. You just keep smushing those up and readjusting them away from the open bag so they don't go all over the counter. Sorry about that first part of the video. I kept trying to express myself and getting distracted by my burping and other things, but what I was trying to do was tell you the many ideas I had for these five ingredients as I laid on the couch all morning thinking about it. And, I was going to make a quiche, and then I tried making, I actually did do a test run to make a flatbread bread pizza. I was going to make some sort of an olive tamponade and spread it on a fried pizza bottom that I had made with the ramen noodles. But the test run of doing that with the ramen noodles, while delicious, didn't hold together well enough. And then I was like, well then, what do you do with this dry, crunchy ramen crust, and then you still have pretzels to incorporate? So, even though this may be the first idea everyone had for these ingredients, and I'm always striving to be different, this is going to be picnicky, yummy, can't fail. Compared to some of the other stuff. Okay, so now I've got the delicious pretzels for the pretzel dogs. And then what I thought I would do, in the spirit of our sort of American approach, see I'm eating the bigger pieces of pretzel out of my dust there, is flavor the egg for this. I'm doing them schnitzel style. Rather than make a tempura, I'm doing flour, egg, crunchy goat. I may do it twice. Sometimes for like twice crunchy pork chops and things, chefs will do it twice. I'll see what I get when I do it once. So there I'm gonna put my sort of American ballpark flavors in there. I'm gonna put a little mustard in my egg. And put a little bit for flavor. You don't want it too wet and gunking up our mix that's supposed to be holding this thing together. And a little bit of sweet relish. And that'll give the sweetness that you have in corn dogs. My complaint with corn dogs is, as wonderful as they seem, I've only had them twice in my life, and both times they were a frozen brand, and both times they were just far too sweet. I just don't want honey-coated. I'm just not, you know, I don't love honey ham and honey turkey and honey this and that. I want either sweet or savory, and in very rare cases, like sweet and sour, I like. But in rare cases do I like them mixed. Like, I don't like it when my maple syrup touches my bacon. People love that. I hate that. So corn dogs for me are just too sweet. It's like ice cream with a hot dog in it or something. I just don't want it. So these I'm making my way. These may be the answer for me, being as snotty and picky as I am. Okay, so I'm going to heat my oil so that this video doesn't take 100 years. I'm going to put those away for later. Put those away. Okay, I'm ready. But I'm not really ready because the oil's not hot yet. I want them to go right in there. And then when I'm done, look what I got. Oh, by the way, I'm using Oscar Mayer cheese-filled dogs. I know they're terrible, but I love them. And they were on sale, two packages for $5. So when I'm done, and it's cool enough to handle, I could just do that and make a corn dog out of it, and make a dog on a stick. I may do that at the end of this video for serving suggestion. But I'm not using a big enough pan to get away with using one of those sticks while it's cooking. And I'm not going to heat a whole bunch of oil for three hot dogs. I'll make Mom and I fresh ones later, or maybe reheat these and add one. She's probably going to be more interested in the pasta salad than the hot dog. So, that's too much flour. I'm going to flick some off of there. Then into the egg, our eggy mustard relish ordeal. And then into our delicious crunchy pretzel mix. I'm just going to sit him over there, let that settle on there. This may be a fail, you know? It's kind of, I probably should have tempura'd this, but You can't win if you don't play. We had a commercial here for years for the lottery, and there was always this sort of Russian-sounding woman who would say, "You can't win if you don't play." That commercial was like 30 years old, but I still say it to this day in her accent. I don't know why. Okay, that looks pretty good. I am a little worried about losing my pretzels, but you never know. The egg may keep it on there. My oil is almost hot now. I'm just going to sort of hang here for a second. Get at least two of them in the pan. Yes, this is a long video. I could have made it two parts, but you know, why make you click around twice and whatever? Let's just do it once. It isn't easy making a salad and a fried pretzel dog in 15 minutes. You know what I mean? Okay, ready? Kablam! Nope, it's not hot enough. So I'll do the other one while that one sort of sits there and soaks up all the oil. I thought my kerblam was going to be so much more dramatic. Oh, you can't even see the pan anyway. Well, then that's a good thing, isn't it? As soon as I finish this one, I'll move the camera angle. I gotta move my computer and all that. In fact, I'll probably go get my little handheld and do it one-handed from now on. You'll have to see the final dog on a stick in the finished plate pictures. I can't do it all. I'm not every woman, you know. Other people are, but I'm not. Okay. I'm going to go get my handheld, and I will be right back. Okay, ladies and gents, here we are at the pan. That's the one that I put in when the oil was still cold, colder. Here are the two latest ones into the oil while it's better than it was. Okay. Now, I'll turn the one that was in there originally. Well, that looks nice. That looks very nice. I'm going to turn them in quarter turns so that they're nice and round all the way around. I think I'm going to start, you know, my last, as I keep complaining about, which I can complain, because that's what I do. I rant, I complain about my thumbnails in the last ones and being just like the sink and like my hands and the bowl and... And I know I have three choices, but often the three choices are always terrible. And but I found that if you do this like three quarters of the way through and then continue talking, then you get your pan shot. So maybe in my cooking vlogs from now on, I'll just, when you see it going in the pan, that's when you know I'm going to start vlogging. Maybe that's my new plan of action. I think eventually YouTube is going to let us all choose a thumbnail to upload. So I can do one of the still photos of the food like the big partners do. But for right now, they don't let us do that. All right. It's a fail in the sense that some of the coating is falling off. But I could have remedied that. I could have taken my time and re-floured it and re-egged it and re-pretzeled it. I also did not crunch the pretzels well enough. So the lazy route of hitting it with the ladle was kind of dumb, because if I'd have taken a rolling pin, I could have gotten that much finer. But, you know what I said about winning. You don't win if you don't play. And there you go. They're looking pretty fine to me, to be honest. I don't see anything wrong with that. Mom will think they're a little strange. But for that, we've got pasta salad. She kept saying, olives and cabbage, olives and cabbage. So... She's all well taken care of in this whole experiment. So there you have it, Neurocosm. My take five on your five ingredients: pretzels, hot dogs, cabbage, ramen noodles, and olives. See you guys next week. Next week will be number four in my series of five. And the grand finale, if you want to go look at that potato video again, it's the one, the take five where I did the potatoes and apples. If you look at the comment section of that video, you will see what Timido66 originally suggested, and I'm going to do hers as the grand finale. See you guys soon. See you for another take five next Tuesday. Hey everybody, I'm back, and mom and a friend of hers was just over, and we dove into the extra hot dog on this thing, and now she's trying the pasta. He already tried the pasta, and they said, oh Liz, this is good. Oh Liz, this is good. So the pretzel dog was a hit, right Ma? The pretzel dog was a hit, and you could taste the pretzel, and you could even taste a little bit of the relish that was in the egg and all of that. I might grind up the pretzels finer next time, but then it would make a weird sort of pasty coating. I like that it had the rubbly crunch. Mom's nodding her head. Yep, she liked the rubbly crunch too. And the salad's great, right? It's got tons of vinegar in it, so it's really, I use that ranch dressing and white vinegar and celery salt. So it's really zingy and zippy, right?
Yes, and takes away the saltiness in the hot dog.
Yeah. It's good. It's a good dish. It's a fun dish. Look how I shoved chopsticks up there, little cheese filling spaces, and do it. It's very nice. See you next time.